Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2130 version 3 with SPI on the Bigtree Tech SKR version 1.4. Now, as many of you might not know, for the X stepper and the Y stepper, in this particular case, the jumpers are in the correct position that they need to be in as a default arrival on the board, which means that they're covering all the red pins for the jumpers down below. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about the board. The board is right here. It's able to do stealth chop, which means that it's going to do quiet printing. It can also do spread cycle. And on that top of that, I'll go into other ones a little bit further in the tutorial. But for now, all we're going to learn to do is install it. Now, also keep in mind that it can detect the end of an end stop with the diag pins so that you don't need to use actual end stops on your axis anymore. But I'll skip that in this tutorial. I'll just peruse over it slightly in the Marlin portion of the tutorial. But I need to let you know that I purchased all the equipment with my own money, and no one sponsoring me or paying me to do the tutorial for you. But I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description in order to help you find it better and offset my costs. Now, one thing I do need to tell you is that there's four sets of ways to power fans on this board. And you should use a cooling fan when using this on your printer, as well as your cooling fins. This is a close-up of the Bigtree Tech TMC2130 version 3. And I need to point out a couple of landmarks. First of all, we have our trim pod over here. The trim pod is normally used to adjust the current going to your stepper. But in this case, we're not using it. We're doing it via software. The other thing that I need to point out is we have a place right here where we're going to place our cooling fins to wick away the heat. I'll do that in just a few moments. But over here, we have our enable pin. This will enable us to figure out how to connect it to the SKR version 1.4. Now, there's also other pins that are of interest. There's the direction pin and the ground pin over here. If you've watched my previous tutorial, I pointed out where the enable pins are. This is the enable pin for the X stepper. This is the enable pin for the Y stepper. This is the enable pin for the Z stepper. And this is the enable pin for E0. And here is E1. So in order to install this, because the jumpers are in the right position when your board arrives, keep in mind that they've marked the yellow, which matches the red on the board, and then the black will match the black. That's another way to tell. So to place this in the X stepper, all you need to do is match up where the pins go and apply a little bit of pressure. Now do the same for the Y set of pins. You'll do it as so. And then we're going to place the cooling fins on top now. So they're going to go basically on the gold plate on top. Now to program it, what we're going to need to do is connect the serial USB. So you're going to connect the big side of the USB over here, and you're going to connect the small side of the USB to your computer, and you may hear a beep. Now, currently it's not beeping because it's in the default configuration as it arrives. So I'm going to remove the USB for a moment and take the jumper and move it over to the next set of pins and put it back on. Now I'm going to reconnect the USB. And you should hear the beep now, and it should power. Okay, first things first, as you can see, the firmware from the USB drive where our micro SD card is, or TF card, shows that the firmware from the last update was on the 29th at 4:21 p.m. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go to VS Code. And we're going to go to the Marlin folder. This is actually an extracted version of Marlin 2.0.x, which is the current release version. And we're going to go to source core, and we're going to go to boards.h. We're going to do a search on SKR. And as you can see, board underscore big tree underscore SKR underscore V1 underscore 4 is now been added to the boards file. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. We're going to minimize core and source and go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, we're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. And we're going to paste what we just copied. And then we're going to scroll up and we're going to change serial port from 0 to negative 1. And now we're going to search on A4988. And as you can see, these are all our stepper drivers. They're currently commented out. So we're going to remove the comments for a couple of them here for our X stepper, our Y stepper, our Z stepper, and E0, which is our first extruder. The next thing that we're going to do is, because it's a TMC2130, we have to actually replace this name. So I'm going to find TMC2130 up here, copy it, and replace it for the two that we're currently using. So this is going to be for both X and for Y. Now keep in mind, I've talked about this before in a previous video, but for default access steps per unit, with this particular stepper, being the TMC2130, you can step between 1/16th of a step and 1/256th of a step. Now, most people don't have a lot of success with 256th of a step, so keep that in mind. You might not want to go that high. But in the case of my previous tutorial, I talked about that the A4988 and the DRV8825 had a difference in steps of 1/16th versus 1/32nd. In this case, if you were to double the number of steps that you wanted to do, you may have to change this to 160 to do 1/32nd. If you were to do 1/64th of a step, it would be 4 times that, so it would be 320. And then if you were to do 1/128th of a step, then it would be 5 times that. So basically it's doubling every time. So it's 80, then 160, then 320, and so on and so forth, as you can see. So I'm going to leave that alone for now because it's not really relevant at this point for you. And we're going to go over to configuration underscore advanced.h, and we're going to do a search on X underscore R sense, and this will bring us to where we need to do modifications. Now right now it has a default current to run our stepper. Now keep in mind that this is based on the peak current. So keep in mind that you're going to need to consult your data sheet for your stepper and for your NEMA 17 stepper motor in order to configure this. That's why I'm not going to cover it closely, but keep that in mind. And also, if you want to change the number of steps, there's also micro-stepping here, which is done through interpolation. So you can do 1/16th of a step. And if you change this to 32, then it will be 1/32nd. And you can change it to 64, which would be 1/64th, and so on and so forth. So keep that in mind. Now we're going to leave alone our sense because it's correct for the moment. But I'm going to change this down to 700, just so you can see the contrast between that and 800, which won't be very much, but it'll show you how to reduce your current to increase how quiet it prints. So the next thing I want to show you is we need to enable a couple of things. So I'm going to see if I can scroll down and find it while I'm talking with you. One of the things we do have to open up is this. It's TMC_use_software_SPI, which is serial peripheral interface. And this is basically saying use your pins file defined for your board to use the correct pins. So when I say that, I'm going to go over to source for a second. Then I'm going to go over to pins, and then on this particular board, our chipset is the LPC1768, and then our board for our pins _BTT_SKR_V1_4.H is the definition of the pins on your board. So we're going to scroll down for a second, and I'm going to show you the X stepper. So right here are software-defined pins. So this means that we can actually point to this file and use these pins for our serial peripheral interface or SPI. So keep in mind that this is your chip select pin, so that may be of importance if you need to change it for something else. But for now, I'm not going to cover it in depth, but at least you'll understand conceptually what I'm talking about. So I'm going to close out of this. So now that we have that enabled, we're going to scroll down a little further and look around. Now, Stealth Chop, this is what keeps prints from making a lot of noise with your motors. If you're not using one of these, you can always comment it out by putting 2/// in front of it. But we're going to leave that alone for now. And keep in mind, if you do put /, in front of it, you'll be changing it to a spread cycle mode, which is slightly noisy because it is using more current and making more noise mechanically. So we're going to skip the rest of this for now. And then I'm going to scroll down a little bit more and see if we can find some other things. We have monitor driver status. We need to enable this as well. The reason for that is up here we have debug commands that we can use to get an idea of what's happening. The one that we'll probably be using specifically is M122, which reports the driver parameters, basically tells us if it's okay or broken. So that's kind of important to us. And then down here, if you wanted to use hybrid threshold, this is a way to jump between Stealth Chop and spread cycle mode at certain thresholds. I don't want to recommend using this to you at the moment. I just want you to be aware of it. So in the future, if you want to try it on your own, you'll know what you're in for because it's going to be somewhat complex. And so I'm going to scroll down a little bit more and show you a couple other things here. We have something now for sensorless probing. A lot of people have asked me how to set this up for sensorless homing. So for sensorless homing, this shows us the X and the Y end stops without actually using end stops, which is one of the main advantages of the TMC2130 SPI configuration. And what that means is when the current starts to rise and it's reaching a wall, or an end stop in this case, being the end of your axis, it will turn the motors off, depending upon the sensitivity that you give it. So to enable that, you would remove the common, but down here you would set the sensitivity. So you can go either lower or higher to figure this out. It depends on your machine, so I don't want to give you too much advice on this, so I'm going to skip it for now. And the last thing that I want to actually enable is TMC debugging, which is someplace around here. So I'm going to remove the comment. Now that that's removed, we need to prep our platformio.ini file. And currently, right now, it's set to a default environment of Mega AT Mega 2560. We need to change that to our chipset, which I just showed you a moment ago, which is the LPC1768. So now that we have that confirmed, all we need to do to upload is press the upload button, which will build, or as some people like to call it, compile. And then it will upload to our port that is available that it can sense if you have one of these devices connected to your computer. So I'm going to click that, and in a few minutes, I'll explain a little bit further on what we can do with this. As you can see, the update has taken place. We now have a firmware.bin, and we also have our firmware.cur, which some people call current. It's also a cursor file extension. But in order to load this, what we need to do is remove the power from the USB and then place it back in so it can load. But before I do that, I want to check to make sure the build was successful. So inside VS Code with Platform IO loaded as a plugin, we can scroll up and check to see that our chipset completed successfully. And it took just over 3 minutes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and show you the update. So I'm going to remove the power for the USB. Now I'm going to replace it. And note that the time has updated to today's time for the current build. Okay, in order to prepare the board for using it with the external power, we need to de-energize the board by removing the USB and then taking this jumper and moving it over to here and then pushing it down. Then we're going to re-energize first with this, but there's going to be no power, as you can see. And then we're going to take our power and plug it into the wall. I have to warn you that the board is now energized with 12 volts and I don't know how many amps of electricity. So do not touch the board, one, because you don't want to damage your equipment, and two, you don't want to harm yourself. Okay, I've just come back to the firmware folder for a second for the USB, but I'm going to go to the desktop. Then I'm going to go to print run. I'm going to open up Pronerface. And I'm going to connect to the printer. As you can see, it said connecting. And printer is now online. So what we're going to do is we're going to check to make sure everything's okay by typing M122 and pressing enter. And as you can see, it tested both the X and the Y, and they say that they're okay. So we're going to move the X stepper 100 steps and see what actually happens. Now we're going to do the Y and see what happens. Now, one last thing. Just keep in mind that if you're installing this on a new printer, you may have to make changes to invert the direction of your stepper within Marlin. And I want to thank you for taking the time to watch my video. And please like and subscribe.